Hi, I'm Dr. James Machino, and I want to talk to you today about dietary choline and its relationship to the prevention of memory loss and dementia and also Alzheimer's disease. So what is choline? Choline is an essential nutrient that's used by the brain to make the memory chemical, which is known as acetylcholine. So the brain makes a chemical that it needs for us to have memory called acetylcholine, and you need choline to make that. But nerve cells also use choline for something else. In order to make the outer skin of the nerve cell, you also need choline. And in that role, choline helps the nerves sort of transmit electrical impulses so that nerve cells can speak to each other. Here's what's interesting. As we get older, as the brain ages, it has a more difficult time absorbing choline. And so there's less brain choline levels as we get older. The result of that is that the brain can't make as much acetylcholine, which is the memory chemical, as we get older. This is particularly important after the age of about 55. So what we've seen, because this has been known for a while, certain studies have been done using choline supplements like CDP choline and other forms of choline, but CDP choline is a great one. And using choline supplementation like this, we've seen that you can raise the brain levels of choline and acetylcholine, and it's been used successfully in cases of dementia and post-concussion syndromes, as well as some early stages of Alzheimer's disease, part of the complementary management. But in 2011, there was this landmark study that really shed even more light on the importance of dietary choline. The study was done by Rhoda Ah and colleagues at Boston University School of Medicine, where they analyzed data from the Framingham study involving about 1,400 adults aged 36 to 83 years old. These adults completed a dietary survey and underwent testing for memory and other cognitive abilities, including an MRI brain imaging scan. The subjects who reported high choline intake from food performed better on memory loss tests as compared to those reporting lower intakes. Additionally, the study participants with the higher choline intake levels were less likely to show on MRI scans of the brain what's called white matter hyperintensity areas. And those white matter hyperintensity areas are areas where there's been sort of blood vessel disease that would affect how the brain's going to function. It's a very common finding, actually, in depression and schizophrenia. But it's not a good sign that the brain would undergo this. So choline seemed to prevent that from occurring, as well as helping to maintain better memory in the people who were ingesting more choline. So the study authors conclude that in this community-based population, high concurrent choline intake was related to better cognitive performance than people who were getting less choline. So where do you get choline from food? Because that's where these people were getting it. Green leafy vegetables, fish, peanuts. Organ meats have choline, but I wouldn't suggest that you get your choline there. I don't think it's a good idea. Soybeans, yeast products like brewer's yeast, wheat germ, lecithin. And this study really adds to the body of evidence that diet, supplementation, and lifestyle strategies are the most important ways to prevent age-related memory loss, Alzheimer's disease, dementia, possibly even Parkinson's disease, which has a lot in common with these diseases. But choline itself is not the whole story. There's been all kinds of evidence to show the importance of diet and supplementation and lifestyle factors. You really need a comprehensive approach in order to prevent Alzheimer's and dementia as you get older. Now, Alzheimer's disease is now the sixth leading cause of death in our society. And after age 55, all of us start to show some cognitive decline just simply because we're not making enough of acetylcholine as we made when we were younger. So to better understand this, when you put the right diet and lifestyle and supplementation program together, what you can do is combat free radicals that are damaging the brain, which are related to Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. You can maintain higher levels of the memory chemical in the brain called acetylcholine. You can reduce brain inflammation that's associated with brain damage and Alzheimer's. You can prevent vascular dementia by not clogging up your arteries with fat and cholesterol and plaque. And by keeping your blood sugar lower, you don't sugarcoat some of the proteins in the brain. There's now a thing called type 3 diabetes, where people with higher blood sugar levels, people who are overweight, are actually sugar-coating proteins in the brain. This is also linked to an increased risk of Alzheimer's as a person gets older. And so there are supplements and dietary factors and lifestyle behaviors that can help to maintain memory chemicals, increase blood flow through the brain, decrease brain inflammation, improve nerve transmission through the brain, improve the fluidity of the nerve cells so that they remain their more youthful morphology or appearance and function. And even you can even slow the brain shrinking that normally occurs after the age of 60 in all of us. So there are these dietary and supplementation and lifestyle practices that are vital to do this. I'm emphasizing this because the drugs for Alzheimer's disease are really not working. They're not the whole answer. People still die on average within 7 years after developing Alzheimer's disease. So you have to know how to prevent it. And yet only 1 to 2% of all Alzheimer's disease is actually based on heredity. So we know it's lifestyle and the aging process itself that actually is creating the problem that leads to brain atrophy and degeneration. And we're seeing that your proactive lifestyle choices are the main thing that are going to preserve your brain health, your memory function, preventing dementia, and also Alzheimer's disease. So the key is to slow down those age-related changes. You need a comprehensive plan to do that. My problem is that most medical doctors haven't studied enough nutrition and natural medicine to really give this advice to their patients. So what I've done is I've put it all together into an ebook that's explained right here, and you should download it. It's called The Nutritional Guide to the Prevention of Memory Loss and Alzheimer's Disease. You should download it right now because, you know, your brain health and your ability to preserve your memory as you get older is a vital part of your quality of life and even your longevity. So now at machinohealth.com, you'll also see my other research review papers. You'll see videos I've created, footage from my live professional seminars, other downloads, resources, things I've put together for free that you can get access to that'll help you lead a long, healthy, functional life. All my research papers and my teaching materials, including the ebook on memory loss, has all the scientific references in it, so you know that this is solid scientific evidence-based information that you're getting, that I didn't just pull it out of the sky, or it's not just based on theory, it's what the scientific evidence is showing. So you really should use machinohealth.com as an ongoing, reliable resource for health and wellness information for both you and your family. Thanks so much for watching.